But yeah, we're gonna do like, it'll be like a video blog on our site. So, I guess look good too. Okay, so we are here today with Steve Ango. He's one of our own in our gym. And he is a 4x games athlete, 3x on the podium. Is
it? 2x.
2x, what's your placing?
2nd, 5th, 4th, and 2nd.
All right, so awesome. And your first 2 years were in the 55 to 59?
No, it's always been in the
60. It's always 60 plus? Okay. Yeah. So he's always dominated the 60 plus division.
Yeah.
So just tell us a little bit about yourself, how you got into CrossFit, what you do for your work. Just give us a little background.
Actually, how I got into CrossFit, the Thorbex was just getting, I think I started when they first got their CrossFit license in January 2013. Dr. Matt has a lot of patients that were doing CrossFit up in Seattle, and he got into it and was telling me about it, and then I think my youngest daughter started coming to classes here, and then so I just started coming and got my butt kicked all the time by the girls.
Yeah, by the girls.
I still remember
I remember
doing pull-up workouts and having to use a band.
Oh yeah.
On pull-up workouts and just, oh my goodness.
You've come a long way. And so you referred to Dr. Matt. Let's clarify who that is. Dr. Matt.
He's my son. He's a naturopathic doctor.
Yeah, and we'll come back to that because
okay.
He helps you a lot
right.
in your nutrition and stuff like that. Would you say that you've always been super athletic, competitive? Were you in sports growing
up?
Yeah,
I mean, I've always done, you know, all the sports, baseball, football, basketball. I mean, we just play lots of basketball and golf, racquetball.
So everything,
yeah.
A little bit of everything.
Yeah.
Were you ever
hiking.
Like competitive, like?
Never, nothing, not in college or anything. Played some high school sports, football and golf, but that was it. But I mean, I've been on team basketball teams, city teams, and softball teams, city league, and all that kind of stuff.
So
did the P90X and. Insanity workouts for a long time until I found out about CrossFit.
So you've always been competitive?
Well, trying to, just because, you know, I'm a CPA, I work behind a desk, especially tax season, you work just sitting all the time.
Yeah.
And so it was just a nice stress reliever.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And just to kind of unwind.
Yeah. What would you say drives you and motivates you most? Especially when you're out on the competition floor at the CrossFit Games, what are you thinking about?
Oh man, just you're not thinking about much of anything, just trying to get through this. But I mean, it's I definitely am competitive. Yeah, I mean, I'm not as bad as I used to be. I used to be just competitive and get in arguments and things like that playing.
I can't see that now. I can't either.
But I've definitely toned it down, but I, you know, I like the competition. I think the biggest thing is just, I didn't do CrossFit to compete.
Mm-hmm.
I did CrossFit because I think it's a lifestyle and I enjoy the workouts. I mean, I want to be in shape.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I want to change people's perspective that, okay, you're 60, you can't do anything and this and that, and I want to kind of change that to where, hey, life can still be great.
Yes.
You can still be active.
Mm-hmm. I love it.
And you chase around those grandkids.
That's right.
Which leads us into our next question. You have a really big family. How many kids?
4 daughters and 1 son.
And how many?
And then 5 granddaughters with 2 granddaughters coming on the way. So if anybody can help me on how to get a grandson,
yeah.
Or get my son-in-law and son to come through.
Yeah, yeah.
Get some boys in the mix.
How do you balance it all? How do you balance training in here and, you know, for the games and regionals and time with your family?
You know, it's not easy. I mean, my wife has been so good about sacrifice. I mean, the only thing I've tried to do the last couple of years is right after tax season and kind of before I get into training, I'll, her and I'll go for a week or something like 10 days to Hawaii or something, just to give her some time because she has been so supportive. I mean, I think she would be fine if I would just stop. I mean, I'm not going to stop CrossFit, but if I don't compete,
yeah,
that is not...
It's not going to break her heart.
Yeah, that's not going to break her heart at all. So, it you know, it's hard, but, you know, it's... I definitely have enjoyed the 4 years of once you qualify and that time period of... I really enjoyed it most, more than anything, is the time kind of practicing and preparing for the games.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
More so than the games themselves, it's just that time because, you know, we've gone to the track, we've gone swimming, different things. It's just, it's been a lot of fun doing stuff with people and in that way.
Yeah, sometimes I feel like the daily preparation towards the main goal is like more exciting.
Right, the journey is, you know, getting, doing it is definitely been fun.
Yeah, which is the great mindset. Yeah. So what do you do for your nutrition? Do you feel like it's helped you in your performance?
I think so. Just in checking, you know, having my body fat tested and things like that.
Do you feel like you eat like a pretty whole foods diet?
Oh yeah, yes. Oh yeah. I mean, when you have Dr. Matt in your family and then Susie girl gone green, you do not put anything in your mouth. I'm not saying that I haven't, you know, but. Like even stuff my wife bakes, she bakes with the good kind of sugars or, you know, just different, the right kind of flours.
Organic.
Yeah, just everything. We definitely, since I've done CrossFit, and it's kind of even more so because they're coming out with more things that are better for you that definitely eat, you know, I don't eat hardly any bread. But I mean, I'll have some, and I don't feel deprived. I think what happens is you acquire a taste for good whole foods once you start eating them.
Yes.
It's just like, hey, that sounds good. Like if you know, if someone, like I don't eat say if I was to eat a candy bar, it would be a dark chocolate from like an evolved candy bar, something like that.
Yeah.
It would be at least 70% plus dark chocolate because that's supposed to be good for your heart. Mm-hmm. But I wouldn't, you know, there's things I used to like to eat, don't get me wrong. But I don't have any like pop.
Yeah.
Just because the sugars and everything, it's just, if I do like potato chips and like say chips and hummus.
Yeah.
But there are a certain kind of chips that I eat.
Yeah.
And you know, like I'll eat carrots and hummus or celery and hummus, and I know it sounds kind of feel like blah, but you really acquire a taste for food, and it's great.
Which I think that has hugely to do with your performance, and I'm sure over the years as you've like eliminated some of those junky foods, you've noticed how you feel better.
Oh yeah.
Eating.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I was one of the worst junk food eaters and stuff like that.
I can't imagine that.
But I mean, I never eat. I mean, I haven't been like in a say McDonald's for over 20 years.
Yeah.
I just because all of that stuff, it's just that processed food just it'll just kill you.
Yep.
So true.
Yeah. What do you feel like it has been your biggest challenge in CrossFit, in sport? What's your biggest nemesis?
The cardio stuff.
Yeah.
You know, double unders, burpees. I'm a bigger guy. I mean, compared to most of the guys, even in my age group, for the most part, I'm a lot bigger than them. So, like, body weight stuff is harder for me and things like that.
Yeah. But then you can take
and the running, you know, things like that. But I mean, it's gotten better, but I mean, I have a long ways to go.
Don't we all?
Yeah, we all have that thing we can work on.
Yeah.
What would you say is your biggest success or the thing you look forward to? You know, if you went to the games and they were going to throw out a workout, what would you want that to be? What would be your favorite workout?
Just anything, shoulder to overhead or anything. Any of the shoulder to overhead, the clean. I mean, for the most part, I've always won those events. Mm-hmm. But I mean, it was great this last year winning that clean and jerk with the weight they gave us, because we were doing the same weight as the 55 to 59 and 50 to 54 weight. The winning that against some of the competition there, and when it had toes to bar and chest to bar, which I'm not that as good on toes to bar.
Yeah.
And that was really...
It's a confidence booster.
Yeah, that was yeah. that was great.
That was a good one. If you had a choice of one cheat meal, what would it be? Even though you already said you don't eat bad foods. If you had
I mean, like, probably my favorite food my wife makes is quesadillas.
Oh, yeah.
Can't and, I mean, I could eat a lot of that.
Yeah.
More than I should. And so I guess that with guacamole or something like that is really good. It's probably just, they're okay to eat, but it's just, I'm probably not as moderate or temperate with them as I should. I eat too many of them.
Which is okay sometimes, right? Do you have any other questions?
No.
If you could talk to people out there who are like on the brink of just in limbo of really wanting to make a change in their life and their nutrition, or you know, thinking about trying CrossFit, but they're on the edge, what would you say to them to get them to take that leap and make a change?
I think you just start where you're at and just start taking one day at a time, coming into CrossFit and on the food, balancing out your food. I mean, just even with the way you guys are doing the macros and that, or the protein, balancing the protein, the fat, and the carbohydrates. Because I never knew any of that stuff, but really, you know, not only have I heard it from you, I've heard it from Dr. Matt, just so many, and other sources, that's the way to go.
Yeah.
People just think they're, you know, like you can't starve yourself. It's just balancing that, because I know, like, just having my body fat tested, I'm in the 95th percentile for my age group, and it's just, I wasn't there before. I can remember going, my wife and I going to the fair one year at Puyallup Fair, and having my cholesterol checked, and the nurses, after getting the check, she goes, you know, you really need to go see a doctor, because, you know, back then.
Yeah.
And so, but that was before I was, you know, trying to eat the right things and things like that. So it can be done, and it's not something that's going to, you didn't get where you are overnight, and you're not going to get out of where you are overnight.
Yeah.
It just takes baby steps, and just one step at a time. But I mean, I'm just so glad that I'm so glad to do CrossFit. I'm glad to be better just because of the energy and things like that. And it's not, I mean, you're still working at it, but definitely I feel a lot better by doing it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, awesome. Thank you.
One more question. What do you think you're going to do this year? Are you going to aim for that podium again?
You know, this year, Mallory, I just think I'm going to sign up for the Open. I haven't actually yet. And just see how it goes.
No expectations.
It's so hard. I know it doesn't sound like it,
tempting,
but during tax season to try to do the Open, and then it's a couple days right after April 15th to do the qualifier, and you're not getting the sleep, and you know, because sleep is so important to recover.
It is very important.
Yes.
But so we'll see if it happens. It happens, but I'm not. Probably the last 4 years, I definitely wanted it so bad. But now, you know, I'm going to try, but if it doesn't happen, I'm good.
Yeah.
Keep an eye on him. This isn't the last you've seen.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Cool.
That was so good, Stevie.